The 1950s, often called the Golden Age of America, was a time in which the United States prospered both economically and socially. From Marilyn Monroe in filming, to Elvis Presley in music, and from Jackie Robinson in baseball, to TV shows such as I Love Lucy and Leave It to Beaver, everything appeared to be going well for all Americans. Yet, through the photos taken by Vivian Maier, we discovered the dull side of America that was rarely talked about.
Vivian Maier was a very private person who for most of her life kept to herself. She was a street photographer who captured many photographs of everyday life in New York, Chicago, and other places around the world. Maier was not of a high economic status, so she supported herself by being a nanny in the wealthy suburbs of Chicago. For part of her life, Maier resided in New York but traveled to other countries. However, in 1956, Maier moved to Chicago where she spent most of the rest of her life. Much of her work was never publicized until 2007, when an amateur historian, John Maloof, discovered thousands of negatives in a storage locker that was auctioned. The storage locker was auctioned due to delinquent payments. John Maloof dedicated much of his time to reconstructing the street photographer's art, which now forms a part of her renaissance and interest in the art of street photography. Vivian Maier recently passed away in 2009.
Street photography is defined as an art photography that features the human condition within public places and does not necessitate the presence of a street or even the urban environment. A lot of what is widely known as street photography was made in the era of the end of the 19th century through the late 1970s, which was also the period of time where portable cameras became popular. However, Vivian Maier was an American amateur street photographer during the 1950s. Maier's images predominantly depict street scenes in Chicago and New York in the 1950s and 1960s. She took more than 100,000 photographs, mostly of people and cityscapes in Chicago, that were basically unknown until after her death in 2009. An article in the Independent newspaper said, "The well-to-do shoppers of Chicago stroll and gossip in all their department store finery before Maier, but the most arresting subjects are those people on the margins of successful, rich America in the 1950s and 1960s. The kids, the black maids, the bums flasked out on shop stoops." John Maloof, the man who discovered her photos, described her work as elderly folk congregating in Chicago's old Polish downtown, garishly dressed dowagers, as well as the persecution of African Americans, were all fair game for Maier's lens.
Vivian Maier's photographs help us get a glimpse at the lives of average citizens while they roamed the streets of cities such as Chicago and New York. Several of her photos touch on the poverty that existed during the 1950s. Maier's notion of poverty was not unique during the 1950s, as evident in Jack Kerouac's 1957 novel, On the Road. Throughout the novel, poverty is widely apparent. When Sal Paradise and Dean Moriarty arrived in Chicago, they were, quote, "suddenly on Madison Street, among hordes of hobos, some of them sprawled out on the street with their feet on the curb." Vivian Maier's photographs also evoke race relations, which were a prevalent yet volatile subject at the time. With the Brown v. Board of Education Supreme Court case in 1954, which declared segregation in public schools unconstitutional, the Emmett Till murder in 1955, the rising popularity of Jackie Robinson, the first black player in Major League Baseball, and the Montgomery bus boycott in 1955, which centered around Rosa Parks' refusal to give up her seat on the bus to a white man, America was beginning to move down the road of desegregation across the country. In several of Maier's photographs, blacks and whites are voluntarily mingling together, whether they are young children or adults. The ideas of interracial relationships is also brought up in On the Road, when Sal, a white man, has a romantic short-lived fling with Terry, a Mexican-American, during the summer of 1947. However, Maier's photographs also highlight racial inequality that existed during the 1950s. A possible example of this is a photograph of a black man riding a horse through the streets of downtown New York City in 1954. This wouldn't appear to be unusual, except for the fact that he is riding a horse bareback in the middle of New York City, with cars clearly visible in the background. Another highlight of racial inequality during this time is an excerpt from On the Road, in which Sal wishes that, quote, "I were a Denver Mexican, or even a poor overworked Jet, anything but what I was so drearily, a white man disillusioned. All my life, I'd had white ambitions. That was why I'd abandoned a good woman like Terry in the San Joaquin Valley." While in Denver, Sal was working in a Denver fruit market, unloading produce. Back then, as is still today, minorities typically performed these tasks. In addition, whites were not expected to perform these tasks, even more so today. Whites are and were expected by society to have better jobs than minorities, something that is true yet disheartening.